So that's fine. Let's take another case study now, which will be this board component, which is in fact this admin dashboard. Let's go back to the source code. Here, as you can see, there is a Scrum board service, fuse confirmation service injected there, a form builder, and change detector ref. I will start by doing the same as I did before, which is adding new containers and presenters folders, then copy paste my component under containers, or move it under containers and copy paste it under presenters. So I need to rename it by adding container to the container component and add also this suffix to the selector, to the template URL, and the style URL. But I think that maybe we will have no need for the styles. I expect them to be just in the presentation component. So let's copy this suffix. And I need to rename the files as well. Let's remove this form from the container, the injection of form builder. And I need to remove the injection of these two services from the presentational component. Okay, and in order to not forget it, let's go to Scrum Board module again and add the container. Ah, it's already there, so I need to add, in fact, the presenter and adjust the name and the path. Okay, that's fine. And I also expect that this container is used in the routing. Yes, the name is adjusted here, but if it is not adjusted, make sure that in the routing, the container is used and not the presenter, because the container is a wrapper for the presenter. So the routing is done correctly now. Okay, let's check what do we have in the template. So we have the board title, and we have this list. Each list contains a list of cards. Let's check in the presenter where the service is used. So we have here a subscription for board, and whenever there is a change, the value of board should be updated. And here we have a mark for check in order to detect these changes, to fix the detection of the changes. By using the async pipe, we can fix such cases where we are forced to use the change detector ref after getting a new value. When the reference is not changed, then the change detection mechanism will not work correctly in Angular, but change detector ref and its method mark for check will help us. So let's make now board as input, just like we did in the other component. And we need also to add it to the template of the container. Let's copy paste it, copy from our previous component and go to the container. Oh, I haven't cleaned it up yet. Okay, this is how we will do it. Let's take the selector of the presenter component and paste it here. Then I can add my input. I need to go back here because I need also to take this line and add it to the container. I no more need this board. And to make sure that I haven't done any error, this is from Scrum Board Service. Scrum Board Service, this is correct. Okay, we have our first input. Let's remove this subscription. I would like to have my own destroy method at the end of my component. So Here in the add list, we have here a call for create list. So I will do it this way, this create list emit. And I need to add create list as an event emitter. And it's an output. Okay. Let's check what should be the type of this one. So create list, I need to check in fact the type in the service, which is here. Okay, it's list. Let's go back to the presenter, to our event emitter, and just add list. And then we need to add this new output, create list, and I can name it on create list and event. Now I need to add on create list in my container component. Okay, let's add it after the on init lifecycle hook. It should return void, and it should call the scrum port service create list method. Let's move the on destroy lifecycle hook to the end. Okay, I have my new method here. Okay, let's check what other errors we still have. Okay, we have also the update list. Let's do it this way, update list dot emit and subscribe. Okay, we need to do the same here. There is a new event emitter, update list, and on update list. Let's add the method. It should do almost the same as create list, just call the update list from the scrum board, from the scrum board service. Okay, fuse confirmation open. Let's fix this delete list also. Init. Delete list. And the ID is a string of null. Okay. We have delete list. Let's add also delete list here. And on delete list. Copy paste. Delete. Here also delete. And here I should give ID, which is string of null. Okay, I will fix it later. Let's move to this line. So I need also update card as event emitter and update lists. So update lists and create card. Okay. Let's wire them here. The template, update lists, and create card. And on update lists and on create cards. So here we need more methods. Copy paste, and let's adjust them. Lists and create card. Okay, so here I am expecting God. We type God, and here let's adjust the name. And update lists, expect a list, an array of lists. Need to fix the event emit types in the presentation component. Okay, let's check what do we have again. Oh, we need also update cards. Emit. So new event emitter. I think the type should be a list of cards. They can check it later. Let's copy paste, adjust the name, and update clouds. Copy paste again, and update clouds. Yes, the type should be, as I have expected, an array of cards. So here, this is fine. We have less errors here. Okay, we need to move the fuse confirmation service injection from the container to the presenter. Okay, and let's clean up the ng on init lifecycle hook in the container. So the form logic is now in the presentation or component. The board observable is declared above, so we can remove these lines. What do we have again? A rename list, add list, update list, dropped, card dropped. Calculate position. Okay, all of them belong to the logic which is now defined in the presentational component. Let's clean up. No need for those attributes. This one as well. And I think no need for unsubscribe all. Yes. I can clean up my ng on destroy lifecycle hook and remove the unneeded imports. No need for subject. Okay, let's go to the presenter again. So now we are facing this problem. We have here a delete list method, and we have also delete list event emitter. So we can rename one of them. Let's rename this to on delete list. I think it's used in the template. Let's look for it. Delete. Yes, and I need to rename it to on delete list. Okay, let's go back and check again where this delete list used. So it is used here as an event emitter. We have on delete list method which calls delete list emit to emit the event. And what do we have also? That's it. So let's check if unsubscribe all is still needed. No. So let's clean up now and remove this line and also remove the import of the subject. Okay, we can also remove the implementation of onDestroy since it's empty. And we can do the same in the container since the hook is empty. Okay, I need also to check if this change detector graph is also needed. As I see, it's just used once, so I can remove it and clean up the import section. Okay, I think I'm ready now to build the application again. Let's run ng-serve. Looks fine. Let's go to the browser. Open the console and refresh it. Okay, as I can see, it looks fine. Let's open a card. Okay, this is a card. Let's type, yeah, it's working. Let's try to edit the name of the list. For example, work in progress instead of in progress. Okay, it's working. Drag and drop is also working. Let's try to adjust the date and close. Okay, it looks fine. Let's check what I have changed. So my changes now are done in the routing. I have used the container instead of the previous component, which is now presentation component. So the container should be used in the routing. I have also added my container component in the declaration to the declaration block in the module, and this is my container and how it looks. It's very clean. I have forgot something. I need to check if I still need this style sheet file here. If I go to the presentation component and look for CDK, I see that there is a number of results. But if I go to the container template and I look for it, I don't find anything, which means I don't need this SCSS file. Let's remove it and clean up the style URL here and make sure that there is no error. Okay, everything fine. Let's refresh the browser. And there is no error on the browser as well. Let's go back to commit. And this is my container TypeScript. I need to remove the change detector from it. It's not needed. And this is how its template look like. I have here on the bottom the router outlet, and they have here the call for the presentation or component. Here I give an input and I expect six events that would be emitted, and I have to react to them as a container component. And this is our presentational component. It had before 320 lines, and now it have 252 lines. It's also cleaner than it was before. Here I haven't changed a lot of things except letting the router outlet call stay in the container, and this wrapper div is now in the container. So guys, that's it. I hope that was insightful. If you like the video, don't forget to hit the like button and to subscribe to the channel. And see you next time.